Welcome to the second video of Type 2. Today we're going to look at something very cool. But before that, I want to thank everyone that watched the first video and sent messages and, you know, gave me motivation to continue. What we're going to discuss today is the relationship between glucose and insulin. Now, if you go on YouTube and look for insulin, you'll have maybe more than 1,000 videos on insulin. And what most people will tell you is that insulin is the key that unlocks the door for the glucose to get in, to get into the cells. But today we'll see the real relationship between glucose and insulin and see who is the boss, who is controlling who. Let's say these are blood vessels.
I will draw the pancreas.
It's kind of ugly, but.
And let's take one
beta cell
outside.
So what everyone knows is that glucose will come into your blood, and then the beta cells of the pancreas will produce insulin. And insulin will get the glucose into the cells. But many people do not know how. And it's not like a key that will unlock the door, but it's actually something really cool. Let me tell you, inside the cells, especially muscle cells and fat cells, glucose has its own private jet. And we call them glucose transporters. They stay inside those cells. When insulin binds to the receptor on the cell, on the cell's membrane, there are some signals inside the cells. Medical students will understand this, but for the other people, just know that cells communicate. They communicate within themselves and they communicate with each other. But they don't use Twitter or Facebook. They have some signaling pathways.
Now, this will make these vesicles that have glucose transporters to move
to the membrane. To get into the cells. The thing is, if we stop here, then most people are right that insulin will get glucose into the cells. But insulin does not stop there. Insulin is an anabolic hormone. Anabolic hormone, that means it promotes growth. Insulin will make you bigger. By increasing protein synthesis,
and even take some
amino acids into the cells. Increase protein synthesis,
that means
you will go from this one to this one. Insulin can make you bigger. Insulin can also promote lipogenesis, basically storing fat. So insulin can also take you from this one to this one. And insulin can also promote the storage of glucose as glycogen.
And insulin can also use other pathways like
MAP kinase pathway
to
promote proliferation, means quick division of cells.
For example, you have one cell, they quickly divide into two, quickly into four,
eight, and the list goes on. You see a lot of people saying that insulin can promote cancer. If something can help them divide, obviously, you know what's going to happen, right? And insulin can also do other things. Cancer cells are not supposed to survive, because all the cells in your body have something in them that if something goes wrong with the cell, they will kill themselves. This is beautiful. You know, they sacrifice themselves for the body. But insulin can also stop some of that, can also stop apoptosis, which if it happens to be a cancer cell, you know, but these things we're not going to discuss here. So insulin can make the glucose get into the cells and can make the cells use the glucose or store the glucose as glycogen or as fat. And insulin can also make the cells take amino acids
and fatty acids, for example.
That's why those patients that have a lot of insulin in their blood are normally obese or fat, because insulin can make you fat, can make you bigger, can make you grow, can make your cells stop dying even if there's something wrong with them, and can make your cells divide quicker and become larger and many. So this is clear. But then who makes insulin comes from beta cells? This is the important question. Because if the beta cells just release insulin for no reason, then we can blame the beta cells. Say, why are you releasing all this insulin if you know they would make us fat? But actually, beta cells do not release insulin by themselves. On the surface of beta cells, there are some private jets, glucose transporters. On this one, we call them glucose transporter 4. And they are inside the cells. When insulin binds to receptors, they are moved to the membrane. But for the beta cells, they are there already. Glucose transporters 2. So when the glucose goes up
after you eat,
the glucose will just get in for free. Now here, glucose will go into glycolysis and through a lot of steps, just know that at the end, there will be production of energy in the form of ATP. And these ATP, see what they will do. On the surface of the beta cells, there are also some channels called potassium channels. And these channels normally allow potassium, which is positive, to go outside of the cells so that the cells can cool down. But this ATP will block these channels. So the potassium will not go outside. And the cells will get more positive. Now there's another channel, the last one. Calcium channel. Calcium channel. These calcium channels, they're voltage sensitive. When the cells get hot, they will open and a lot of calcium will get in. A lot of calcium will get in. And these will link the insulin, which was already here, to the membrane. This is what the calcium will do. Then the insulin will get released into the blood. So what did we see here? That insulin can promote growth, can promote proliferation, can promote a lot of stuff. But glucose is the one that gives orders to the beta cells to release insulin. Because when glucose gets in, everything else that happens is automatic. So at the end of the day, who is making you fat? Now write your comments down.
And tell me, who
is making you fat? The insulin that promotes all this, or the glucose that is making the insulin promote all this? That's why sometimes after church, we go somewhere to eat with friends. And I don't drink any sugar drinks. They keep asking me why. And sometimes when I don't go, they say, okay, he's not here today, so we can enjoy our drinks. But the thing is, I can't. Because I know that those things are high in sugar. They will get into my blood, they will go into my pancreas, and they will force my pancreas to release insulin. Insulin will get the glucose into the cells, and amino acids into the cell, fat acids into the cell, and will promote storage of fat here, and here, and here, and here, and here. And apart from that, these pathways can also stop the use of any storage that you have. It doesn't matter if it's glycogen, it doesn't matter if it's fat, if you have fat stored here. Insulin will stop the breakdown of those fat. So you will stay fat, and then it will make the cells put some more fat. With this understanding, if you give sugar drinks to your children, do you love them or you hate them? I know this is a deep question, but just write them down. I want to see them. Anyway, if you do it once in a while, it's okay. But if you do it often, just know what you're doing to yourself. Just go to your calendar and start cutting days. Say, okay,
today,
I made my life shorter
by 5 days.
And tomorrow,
minus one day, minus 10.
Just keep doing that. Every time you drink those stuff. You know why I enjoy these things? Because before I got into the medical school, I was very afraid of diabetes. Because in my family, a lot of people have diabetes, and some have died with diabetes. So it was something that I always had inside. I knew that this was something that, you know, we were supposed to go through. But after understanding what's really going on, I can tell you confidently that I will not have type 2 diabetes, because this thing is easy to fix. So if you like this video, you can give it a thumbs up and subscribe and allow the notification so that when I release the next one, you will know. Be blessed. Bye.